वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल रेस्पेक्ट एजुकेशन। हेलो एवरीबॉडी, नाउ वी सी वर्कशीट 4। दिस वर्कशीट बिलोंग्स टू चैप्टर 1, दैट इज केमिकल इक्वेशंस एंड रिएक्शंस। ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी रॉम नंबर 1, दैट इज मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस। इन विच क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, a precipitation reaction is one in which two soluble reactants form an insoluble product. Here product should be insoluble and the reactant should be soluble, right? Now the insoluble product is a solid which usually sinks to the bottom of the liquid. The table shows the solubility of compounds that form when some chemicals react. The compounds that are soluble are marked with a tick, right tick. The compounds that are insoluble are marked with a cross. Now let us see here. Certain, okay, barium, lead, mercury, potassium, they are given. Sodium, here their carbonates, chlorates, hydroxide, nitrate and sulfate. Now here certain questions are there, let us answer them. Which of the following word equations represent a precipitation reaction? Now let us see here. Sodium nitrate, see here, sodium and nitrate, here tick mark is there, so this is soluble. Barium chloride, barium, again chloride, tick mark is there, so it is soluble. Sodium chloride, sodium, and again here chloride, tick mark is there, soluble. Barium nitrate, barium and nitrate, tick mark is there, so soluble. Now mercury sulfate, see in mercury sulfate, it is soluble. Potassium nitrate, potassium, in that nitrate, soluble. Mercury nitrate, mercury, again nitrate, this is soluble. Potassium sulfate, potassium, in which again sulfate, that is also soluble. Now let us see question number C bit. Potassium sulfate, potassium, and then sulfate, it is soluble. Barium hydroxide, barium and hydroxide is soluble. Potassium hydroxide is soluble. Barium and sulfate, here you observe the cross mark, so it is insoluble. So here insoluble I am writing as IS, insoluble. Now potassium chloride, potassium, again chloride, soluble. Sodium hydroxide, sodium with hydroxide, it is soluble. Potassium hydroxide, potassium and hydroxide, it is soluble. Sodium chloride, sodium and chloride, this is also soluble. Here according to the definition of precipitation reaction, see, reactants should be two soluble, means both the reactants should be soluble. Product should be insoluble. See here where we get the, that such kind of reaction, you see here, here soluble, reactants are soluble, in one of the products is insoluble. So option C is the right answer for this question number 1, and remaining options you see, soluble, that's why these remaining options are not correct answers. Now we see question number 2. A student takes copper, aluminium, iron and zinc metal separately in 4 test tubes labeled as 1. See, in the first one he took copper, second one he took aluminium, and third one he took iron, and in fourth one zinc. He adds 10 ml of freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution to each test tube and observes the color of the metal residue in each case. He would observe a gray residue in the test tubes. Now here if we arrange them in the reactivity series, so here aluminium, it is more reactive than zinc, that is more reactive than iron, which is more reactive than copper. So here ferrous sulfate solution, when it is added to these metals, and whichever metals are there whose reactivity series is more than this, means which are more reactive than iron, because here FeSO4 it is added, ferrous sulfate nothing but FeSO4. So which are there more than these? There will be a residue, gray residue in those test tubes only. So residue will be there in aluminium test tube, and then here zinc one. So here option 2 and option 4. So 2 and 4. Option D is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 3. Four students A, B, C and D noted the initial color of the solutions in beaker 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here are 4 beakers. Okay. So after inserting zinc rods in each solution and leaving it undisturbed for about 2 hours, he noted the color of each solution again. So here the given things are aluminium sulfate, zinc sulfate, this is ferrous sulfate and copper sulfate. So here if we arrange them in as per the reactivity series, here it comes like this. Aluminium is greater than zinc, is greater than iron, it is greater than copper. Now here I am writing their initial colors. Here initial means before doing the experiment, means initial color of Al2SO4 3 test like that. And here I am writing the final colors, okay, final color of the solution. So here initially Al2SO4 thrice, the solution color is colorless. This is colorless, right? And here after dipping the zinc rod, since zinc is the lesser reactive than aluminium, so there will be no effect at all. So here final also colorless. Now let us see second one. Now here zinc sulfate initial it was colorless. See, for the zinc again we are keeping the zinc rod only, so here also there will be no change at all, colorless. Now here third one, ferrous sulfate, its initial color it was light green. When we dip the zinc, then here what happens, zinc is more reactive than iron, so here it will become zinc sulfate, will become its color is again colorless, right? Now let us see fourth one, that is copper sulfate. Initially its color is blue. Now after completion of the experiment, since zinc is higher reactive than this, it will displace. So copper will be displaced from its solution, so it will become zinc sulfate again colorless. So here this is again colorless. Now these are the observations. So let us see which one is true here. See, colorless, light green, blue, colorless. Now here let us see the options. Here if you observe options carefully, see here, colorless, light green, blue, colorless. So the student A, he has done, they recorded their observations in the form of given table below. Which student noted the color change in all the 4 beakers correctly? So student A, that too option A. So option A is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 4. Zinc granules are placed in each of the 4 solutions. Here A, that is aluminium sulfate solution. Here B, this is zinc sulfate solution. C has copper sulfate solution and D has ferrous sulfate solution. As shown, color change would be observed in here aluminium, zinc, copper and then here iron. So if we see their reactivity series, it will be like this. Aluminium is more reactive than zinc, which is more reactive than iron, which is more reactive than copper. So here where the zinc color can be changed, so here zinc granules are kept in these solutions. So zinc cannot displace aluminium, so A cannot be the option. Zinc cannot displace zinc itself. Only thing is zinc can displace either iron or copper. So here copper sulfate solution or ferrous sulfate solution, these two will be get affected. So here option C and D, that is option B here, is the right answer. Now we see question number 5. 2 grams of barium hydroxide BaOH twice is mixed with 1 gram of NH4Cl ammonium chloride as shown in the figure. See, this is how they have added. The mixture is stirred with a glass rod. If in the same activity HCl acid is added in place of NH4Cl and the mixture is stirred with a glass rod, then which of the following statement or statements is or are correct about this activity? So here you see, when BaOH twice NH4Cl, when they mix it together, that is called the first case. In first case, the tube will be hot to touch. No, it will be cold to touch because it is endothermic reaction. So this is false. In the second case, means here when HCl is added to BaOH twice, then the tube will be hot to touch. Yes, it is, because it is the exothermic reaction. The two, this is acid plus base will give us salt and water. When HCl is added in place of NH4Cl, the reaction is exothermic, right? That is the reason here, when we touch it, we feel it is hot. When NH4Cl is added to BaOH twice, means like the first case, it is the endothermic, that is true. So that it will become here little bit cool in the first case. In the second case, it will be hot. So here option 2, 3 and 4, these are the correct statements. So 2, 3, 4, where are they here? 2, 3, 4. So here option C is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 6. When an acid reacts with a metal, hydrogen gas and a salt are produced. Shilpa performed an experiment with metals and hydrochloric acid. She set up the equipment as shown below. This is the given equipment. Here is a retort stand, here is a clamp and a syringe, plastic tube, rubber stopper, conical flask in that hydrochloric acid, HCl and metal. The purpose of the syringe was here, why is she using the syringe? What is the use? To collect the salt produced. No, this is not the correct usage. Add acid into the conical flask. No need here. We can add it without using the syringe only. So this is not the purpose. Connect the conical flask to the retort stand, for that clamp is there. So this is not at all means this is not the particular use of using syringe. Here, measure the amount of hydrogen gas produced. Yes, using syringe we are going to measure this. That is the reason she kept syringe. So option D is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 7. Food industry has picked up very fast pace throughout the world. The manufacturers are adding certain substances called antioxidants to the food material. When oxidants are added to foods, the fats and oils present in them do not get oxidized easily and thus do not get rancid. The role of antioxidants in food industry is, here let us see, first one, to act as an oxidizing agent. No, this is not true here. Now, here let us see second option, to act as a reducing agent. Yes, this is true. Now, to promote the oxidation of food, if they get oxidation of food, if the food gets oxidation, again it gets the rancidity. So this is false. To prevent rancidity, yes, this is the reason we are using the antioxidants. The correct statement or statements are here 2 and 4. That is your option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 8. A student set up the experiment below to find out what conditions were needed for rusting to occur. So here he has taken, okay, in test tube A, salty water and some iron nails. So here this gap is for air. In test tube B he kept anhydrous calcium chloride. So here this gap is for air. Test tube C he took boiled water, and here automatically when the boiled water is boiled, so here you get the dry air, and here layer of olive oil also he kept here. And here in test tube D he took distilled water and here dry air. Now the question is that why have calcium chloride and boiling water be taken in test tubes B and C respectively. Actually, the purpose of using calcium chloride, it absorbs moisture. Actually, calcium chloride, it absorbs moisture. And using boiling water, actually boiling water, it lost oxygen. So there will be no oxygen at all. So in these two conditions, the rusting can be minimized. Now here let us see. Okay, let us see the options. First one is absorb moisture. Second one is there should be no oxygen. Absorb moisture and oxygen, wrong. To absorb oxygen and moisture respectively. To absorb both, that is the meaning. So this is wrong. To absorb oxygen and being rich is in being rich in oxygen respectively. This is also false. To absorb moisture means calcium chloride is for to absorb moisture and boiling water having no oxygen respectively. So this is true. So option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 9. The process of coating of iron articles by a layer of zinc to protect it from rusting is called. See, it's when we use zinc layer on iron articles, it is called galvanization. So here either this option or this option. See, in place of P, we can write either any of these two because both are same. It is Q, beneficial as compared to coating with a metal like R. It will be definitely beneficial in the sense we will be seeing more beneficial, right? When with a metal like R, so instead of zinc, if you use tin, with a metal like tin, as here S, corresponding one is rusting. Rusting does not take place even after layer breaks at some place. Choose the appropriate words to fill the blanks in the given above statement. So here option C, if you keep option C in their respective places, then definitely this will be exactly correct. So here option C is the right answer. Now we see 10th question. Sonu wanted to react potassium iodide solution with aqueous solution of lead nitrate to obtain a yellow precipitate of lead iodide. For this, he made the following experimental setup. So he has taken potassium iodide and then lead nitrate. But accidentally, the lead nitrate solution fall down and more lead nitrate is not available in the laboratory. Could you suggest which of the following salt he can use for performing this activity? See, whenever lead nitrate is unavailable, we can use lead acetate in place of it. So here option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 11. Identify gas A in the following experiment. Let us see here. Here he has taken zinc granules, on that he added dilute sulfuric acid. So here let us write the equation. He has taken zinc granules, for that he added dilute hydrochloric, means dilute sulfuric acid, okay, stesophore. Then here we get zinc sulfate and then hydrogen gas is evolved. Let us see balancing zinc and zinc SO4 aspirate. Okay, it is balanced. Now see here, the gas liberated is hydrogen gas, right? How can we test it? When we keep a burning matchstick, it will be put off, okay, with a pop sound. So that is nothing but hydrogen gas. So here which gas is evolved? Hydrogen gas. That is option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 12. That is, in the reaction of iron with copper sulfate solution, that is copper sulfate plus iron gives us copper plus FeSO4. So here, since Fe is the iron is the more reactive than copper, so it will displace copper from its sulfate. So which option in the given table correctly represents the substance oxidized and the reducing agent? In fact, we know that oxidized substance only reduced agent, both are same. Now here our prime duty to check which substance get oxidized. So here you see, For Fe, for iron, here oxygen is added. Addition of oxygen is nothing but oxidation. So here Fe gets oxidized. At the same time, the same Fe will be acting as reducing agent. So substance oxidized and reducing agent, both are the same, nothing but Fe. So option A is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 13. That is, limestone, when it is heated up, it becomes X plus CO2. Again, when the water is added, it becomes slaked lime. Identify the correct option from the given table, which represents the type of reactions occurring in step 1 and step 2. Let us complete the equation first. Limestone is CaCO3. On heating, it becomes calcium oxide. It is also called quicklime. When here to quicklime and carbon dioxide, okay, they both will be liberated. And when it is added to water, you will get slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice. Now here the question is that in step 1, what kind of reaction it is? It is heated, means here heat is given to it. So that is endothermic. So first one is, here I am writing, this is endothermic reaction. It is endothermic. And here, when we add water to quicklime, here heat will be, heat is liberated. So here it is exothermic. It is exothermic. That means here step 1 is endothermic, step 2 is exothermic. So step 1 endothermic, step 2 exothermic. So option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 14. Which of the following correctly represents a balanced equation, chemical equation? So let us see here balancing. See 3Fe, only 1Fe, it is not balanced. 3Fe, 3Fe, and here 8 hydrogens, here also 8 hydrogens, and 4 oxygen. So this is balanced. Let us check the remaining also. 3Fe, 3Fe. Here, 2 hydrogens, 2 hydrogens. 4 oxygens, only 1 oxygen. So it is not balanced. 3Fe, Fe3 means 3Fe. Here, 8 hydrogens. Here, only 2 hydrogens. So this is not balanced. So option B is the right answer. Now we see Roman number 2, that is comprehension type questions, in which comprehension 1 is given as gain of electrons is reduction, reducing property. Elements with high EP and low IP have the property of losing an electron. This property is called reducing property. For example, here sodium, magnesium, aluminium, etc. Here, high EP means high electropositivity. EP for electropositivity. Low IP, IP means ionization potential. So, have the elements with high electropositivity and low ionization potential, they have the property of losing an electron. Okay, this property is called reducing property. These are the examples. Now let us see question number 15 based on this. Loss or removal of electrons from an atom is known as. So whenever there is a loss or some electrons are removed, see gain of electrons when it is reduction, then removal of electrons will become oxidation. So here option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 16. Generally, the element having tendency to lose electrons shows reducing property. So here reducing property. So option B is the right answer. So here you see the elements, it is given in the matter, reducing property. So the same thing, tendency to lose electrons. So here property of losing electron. So from this definition we can write it easily. Among the following good reducing agents are, here metals, non-metals, metalloids, both A and C. Metals are good reducing agents. See here example, sodium, magnesium, aluminium. So almost all metals. So here option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 18. among the following elements which acts as good oxidizing agents. Here oxygen, yes, it will act as oxidizing agent. Fluorine also acts as oxidizing agent. Chlorine also acts as oxidizing agents. So here all option D is the right answer. Now we see comprehension number 2. The main gate of Ravi's house is developing a powdery brown film of substance which is slowly deteriorating the gate. Means here it makes the gate so weak. Okay, it because of that the strength of the gate reduces. He asked his friend Ramu for help, who told him to paint the gate in order to protect it from the deteriorating. So in order to lose it completely day by day, so he asked him to paint it. So here easily we can guess it. What is the brown film of substance? That is nothing but rust. So its formula is Fe2O3.xH2O. This is the chemical formula of rust. Now here let us see some questions based on this. Now we see question number 19 based on the given comprehension 2. What is the chemical formula of the powdery brown film of the substance? So that is nothing but here I told you Fe2O3.xH2O. Fe2O3.xH2O. So option A is the right answer. Let us check the remaining options here. FeO3 is given here. 2 is not given. That's why it is wrong. FE3O3 is given. In fact, it is Fe2O3. So this is also wrong. So it is not none of the above. Here answer is there. This is also called ferric oxide. Now we see question number 20. Which of the following elements undergo corrosion? So here gold, no, it will never get corrosion. Silver, yes, it gets. And platinum, it won't get. So here option B is the right answer. In fact, the rust of the silver is called silver sulfide. Okay, now let us see question number 21. Which of the following is or are the different ways in which the gate can be protected? First, by applying the film of grease and oil on the metal surfaces. Yes, this is the one of the way to be followed. One of the ways. Next, here covering metal surface of metal with another metal which is more electropositive. This is also correct. Covering metal surface with paint. This is also correct. So we can use any one of the methods to prevent the gate. So here option D, all of the above is the right answer. Now we see question number 22. Is the chemical name of the compound formed on corrosion of silver? That is, as I have told you, the corrosion of silver is called silver sulfide. So here option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 23. Conversion of metals into their undesirable compounds like sulfides, carbonates, oxides, etc. by interaction with atmospheric gases and moisture is called, it is corrosion. So here rancidity means if the food gets spoiled, that is called rancidity. Here if the metals get corroded, that is called corrosion. Here alloying, this is the preventing method or preventing procedure of corrosion. Okay, so here corrosion, the main thing is that corrosion, this is the undesirable compound. How do we get the corrosion? By interaction of the metals with atmospheric gases and moisture. So here option B is the right answer. Now we say comprehension 3. In the above image, in fact it is below the image, an experiment is performed where 3 grams of lead nitrate powder is heated in a boiling tube over the flame. We observe fumes of some gas and some solid compound is precipitated at the bottom of the boiling tube. So here as we are taking the lead nitrate powder, so here let us see what happens. Here I am writing the suitable reaction, that is lead nitrate is PbNO3 twice when it is heated up. So here this is simple for heating. We get here lead oxide PbO, and then here gases are evolved, those are nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. Now here let us see the balancing. First of all, NO3 is there 2 times. So here we can increase it by 2, so that here we get 2 times lead, so here 2 times lead. Now it affects the oxygen, and here is nitrogen, 2, 2 are 4 nitrogens are there, here only 1 is there, so let us here 4. Now let us count the oxygens, 2, 3 are 6, 6, 2 are 12 total, so left side total 12, and here these are 2, 2 plus 8, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, so it is balanced. Now here this PbNO3, when it is heated up, it is decomposed into these many things. Here if we observe carefully what happens, so based on that certain questions are there, then we are going to answer them by using this reaction. Here question number 24 is, what is the color of the fumes formed? Actually here two kinds of gases are formed. NO2, it is brown color, okay, reddish brown in fact. So the fumes are of brown color, whereas oxygen is colorless. So here let us see options. Brown color is there, that means this question indicates NO2. So option A is the right answer. Now let us see question number 25. What is the color of the solid compound left at the bottom of the boiling tube? Here what will be left? That is nothing but here lead oxide. So PbO, whose color is here yellow color. Let us see the option. Option C is the right answer. Now let us see question number 26. What is the chemical formula of the gas whose fumes are formed? Here you see NO2 and O2. From the options you see here option D, NO2 is given. So option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 27. What is the chemical formula of the compound left at the bottom of the boiling tube? So here we have seen earlier, this is the reaction which happens here. This is the compound, lead oxide, that will be left here in the, at the bottom of the test tube. So here, lead oxide, that is PbO. So option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 28. What is the type of the chemical reaction happening in the above experiment? Here this experiment is done when heat is given. So here this is called thermal decomposition. At the same time here also a decomposition reaction, okay. So it can be, we know that all decomposition reactions are redox. So here there are two options, either A or D. So now we see comprehension 4, that is in the above image, actually below image, right, 2 grams of silver chloride is taken in a china dish and is kept in sunlight. After some time we observe that the color of the silver chloride changes. Now here we can see that here is china dish, here silver chloride is taken, here sun rays are allowed to fall on that. So let us see some of the questions based on this experiment. Now we see question number 29. What is the initial color of silver chloride? Initially silver chloride has the color of white. So here option A is the right answer. So when it is kept under the sunlight, after some time it turns to gray. What is the final color of the silver chloride? It turns to gray. So option B is the right answer. Now what is the type of chemical reaction occurring in the above experiment? So here this is the called decomposition of silver chloride. So here option C is the right answer. Now let us see question number 32. Which type of reactions are used in black and white photography? As we know, photochemical compositions are used in black and white photography. So here option D is the right answer. Now we see Roman number 3, assertion and reason type questions. Here one assertion along with that one reason will be given. We need to put the option A if both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. We should write option B if both A and R are true and R is not correct explanation of A. We should write option C if A is correct and R is incorrect. We should give option D if A is incorrect and R is correct. Let us see question number 33. Assertion A is given. A chemical reaction becomes faster at high temperature. This is true. Now reason given as, at higher temperature molecular motion becomes more rapid. That is the reason here the reaction becomes faster. So this is the true and this is the correct explanation for it. So here option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 34. Assertion A is given as combustion reactions are called exothermic. This is true because combustion reactions, they give heat. Heat is evolved. So they release heat. That's why this is true. And reason is given as oxygen is added, heat energy is released in combustion reaction. So because of this process only combustion reactions, they give us heat. That is the reason we call them exothermic reactions. So here this is also true and this is the correct explanation for A. So here option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 35. Assertion A is given as, according to the law of conservation of mass, the total mass of the products must be equal to the total mass of reactants. This is true. Now let us see the reason. A catalyst changes the speed of a chemical reaction without itself undergoing any chemical change. This is also true. But the thing is that here R is the not correct explanation of A. So here option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 36. Assertion A is given as, barium chloride reacts with aluminium sulfate to give aluminium chloride and barium sulfate. Here you see barium chloride with aluminium sulfate. So finally we get barium sulfate. Here aluminium and chloride. This is called double displacement. This is true. Now let us see the reason. 2HNO3 plus CaOH twice give us CaNO3 twice plus H2O is a neutralization reaction. This is an acid, this is the base. Acid plus base give us salt and water. So this is neutralization reaction. This is also true. But here R is the not correct explanation of A. So here we can write the option as B. Now we see question number 37. Assertion A is given as, photochemical reactions are A, photosynthesis, B, decomposition of AgBr, or decomposition of AgCl. This is true. So this statement is true. Now let us see the reason. The photochemical reaction takes place in the presence of sunlight. So in the presence of sunlight only here photosynthesis can be done. Decomposition of AgBr and AgCl also can be done. And these reactions are only, they are only called as photochemical reactions. So this is true and moreover this is the correct explanation of A. So here this is option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 38. Assertion A is given as, oxidation is involved in both corrosion and rancidity. This is correct. See, oxidation, if it gets for metal, it is called corrosion. If it gets for the food, it is called rancidity. So this statement is true. During this process, means during the oxidation process or corrosion, both metals and food undergoes reduction. This is wrong. Both undergo oxidation. So this statement is false. Here A is true. A is correct. R is incorrect. So here option C is the right answer. Now let us see question number 39. Assertion A is given as, rancidity can be prevented by storing food in the atmosphere of N2 gas. This is true. Now, because N2 gas is one of the antioxidants, so it can prevent the rancidity. So, I mean, it can prevent the food from the rancidity, right? Now, let us see the reason here. As nitrogen reacts with oxygen, rancidity is prevented. Here you see this statement is false. In fact, here nitrogen is an inert gas. So, here we can write this. Here I am writing the reason. In fact, nitrogen gas is an inert gas. It is an inert gas. Only thing is that it can prevent oils or fats that are presented in food from the rancidity. So here nitrogen, it doesn't react with oxygen, so that it won't be okay, it won't prevent the rancidity in this way. So since it is an inert gas, ఈట్ క్యాన్ ప్రివెంట్ ఆయిల్స్ అండ్ ఫ్యాట్స్ ఇన్ ది ఫుడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది ఆక్సిడేషన్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ వోంట్ అలౌ దెమ్ టు బి గెట్ ఆక్సిడైజ్డ్ సో హియర్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆప్షన్ సి ఈజ్ ది రైట్ ఆన్సర్ బికాస్ హియర్ ఏ ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్ అండ్ ఆర్ ఈజ్ ఇన్కరెక్ట్ నౌ లెట్ అస్ సీ క్వశ్చన్ నంబర్ 40 దట్ ఈస్ హియర్ అసర్షన్ ఈజ్ గివెన్ యాజ్ డిసొల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ quicklime in water is an exothermic reaction. Let us hear how far it is true. When we add water to quicklime, that is exothermic but not redox reaction. So this statement is false. During dissolution of CaO in water, there is no change in the oxidation numbers of any elements. This is true. In chemical reaction, okay, when here especially CaO is water dissolved in water, there will be no change in the oxidation numbers. For example, here we see the reaction becomes CaO plus added in water means H2O gives rise to CaOH twice. Now here calcium oxidation number here plus 2, this is minus 2, here it is minus 2. So that this is plus 2, here also again plus 2, for these two minus 2 and minus 2, or for both minus 2 only. So here is the oxidation numbers, they are not changed at all. So here what we need to understand is that this statement reason R, it is actually statement B, it is given as B, it is R. So this is true. So the 40th one, A is incorrect, R is correct. So option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 41. Assertion A is given as all displacement reactions are exothermic as well as redox reaction. So here this is true, all displacement reactions are exothermic as well as redox. So here statement A is given as true. In all displacement reactions, less reactive element displaces more is wrong. More reactive element only displaces the less reactive element. So this is false. So here if you observe carefully, A is correct or is incorrect. So option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 42. Assertion is given as decomposition of vegetable matter into compost is an endothermic reaction is wrong. Their heat is liberated. So it is exothermic. So this is here false. Decomposition reaction involves breakdown of a single reactant into simpler products. This is true. So here the statement A is incorrect whereas R is correct. So this is here option D is the right answer. Now we see Roman number 4 statement type questions. Here option A should be given if all the given statements are correct ABC. Okay. If B is to be given if all the above statements are incorrect. Suppose A, B, C, all the three are incorrect, then we should give option B. For example, A and B are correct but C is incorrect, then we should give the option C. If A and B are incorrect and C is correct, we should get option D. Now let us see here question number 43. Statement A says that reddish brown copper metal forms a black solid on combustion, means on heating. Definitely copper becomes black. So this is true. So here this is true, correct. Now statement B says milk converted into curd is a chemical change. This is also true. Statement C, corrosion of silver can simply known as tarnishing. So this is also true. So here if you observe carefully, A, B, C, all the statements are true. So here option A is the right answer. Now let us see question number 44. Statement A says that the reagent nascent oxygen responsible for colored objects into colorless objects. This is true. Nascent oxygen, that is only responsible. It will make colored objects into colorless objects. So this statement is true. Dissolving quicklime in water is a combination reaction. So here dissolving quicklime in water, it is a combination reaction because here more, two or more reactants are there and we will get the product, single product. So this is also true. Now let us see statement C. Chemically rust is hydrated ferrous oxide. This is wrong. It is ferric oxide. That is not ferrous oxide. Here it should be ferric oxide. Chemically rust is called hydrated ferric oxide but not ferrous oxide. So this is false. Here you see A and B are correct and C is incorrect. So here for this option C is the right answer. Now let us see statement question number 45. In the statement A, dissolving a quicklime in water produce white precipitate. This is wrong because here it gets dissolved completely. There is no precipitation. This is not precipitation reaction. Now statement B says that rancidity of food is example of reduction. No, it is the example of oxidation. So this is wrong. Statement C says that N2 plus O2 gives to 2NO and minus Q. In this reaction, chemical change is taking place. Definitely chemical change is taken place. So this is true. Here A and B are incorrect, whereas C is correct. So option D is the correct answer. Now we see Roman number 5. More than one correct answer type questions means here more than one, maybe 2, 3, sometimes all 4 may be correct. Question number 46. Which of the following is happened during a chemical reaction? Breaking of old chemical bonds and formation of new chemical bonds. Yes, it happens. Formation of new substances with entirely different properties. Yes, it happens. Atoms of one element can change into those of another element to form new products. No, it won't be happened. A rearrangement of atoms does not involve a chemical reaction. They too will involve. So here this statement is wrong. Now here if we see option A and B, these are only correct options. Now we see question number 47. The reaction between carbon and oxygen can be represented as C plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus heat. In which of the following type or types the above reaction can be classified? Is it a combustion reaction? Yes, it is a combustion reaction because here it is done by adding of oxygen. That means here oxygen is the supporter of combustion. Next, is it a displacement reaction? Here nothing gets displaced. So this is false. Is it an exothermic reaction? Here heat is evolved. So it is an exothermic reaction. Is it a combination reaction? Say two or more reactants to form a single product. So this is combination reaction. So option A, C, D are the correct options. Here I'm writing option A, C and then D. So these are the correct options for this question, that is question number 47. Now we see question number 48. Let us see the question. Ravi set up the following experiment. Which of the following observations were observed by Ravi? Here you see he has taken one conical flask. There he took zinc granules, in that he poured dilute sulfuric acid. So here he used a glass tube for pouring the acid and here he kept a cork, okay, one hold cork. Now let us see the options. Now zinc surface became dull and black. Yes, definitely it can be done. A gas was evolved with which turned lime water milky. This is wrong. Why? Because here if you see the reaction, here we are taking zinc. Zinc is added to sulfuric acid, means H2SO4, so that here he will get zinc displaces hydrogen from it. So ZnSO4 plus hydrogen gas. Here the property of hydrogen gas is it will put off the burning matchstick with the pop sound, but it won't turn lime water milky. Which gas will be turned? CO2 will be turned, but that is not liberated here. So this is false. The conical flask became warm. Yes, it is exothermic reaction. So this is true. The solution becomes yellow. This is wrong. Solution becomes in fact colorless. So here option A and C are the right options. Now we see Roman number 6. Matching type questions. In which question number 49. Column 1 is given. Column 2 is given. See, NH3 plus Cl2 gives rise to NCl3. So chlorine is taken by the nitrogen and here this hydrogen is taken by the another chlorine. So here this is called double displacement reaction. So T, for this option T is the right answer. Now let us see B1. 2Ki plus Cl2 gives us to 2KCl plus I2. That means here what happens, this in place of Cl2, here you see before the K comes here, that means here this is displacement reaction. So here we can say this as S, that is S for displacement. Now let us see ZnCO3 becomes ZnO plus CO2. Single reactant, more products. So this is called decomposition. So this is R. R is for decomposition. And now here MgO plus H2O gives rise to MgOH twice. More reactant single product. This is called combination. So this is Q. Na becomes Na plus means positive nature. Plus E minus means by losing one electron it gets positive nature. This is called losing electron, nothing but oxidation. So this is P. Let us check the options here. A, T, B, S, C, R, D, Q, C, E, P. So here A, T, B, S, C, R, okay, D, Q, E, P. So option A is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 50 and almost all this is the last question of the worksheet. Now match the following. There are two columns are given, column 1, column 2. Fe2O3 plus 2Al gives rise to 2Fe plus Al2O3. Here this is Fe2O3, you see here aluminium displaced Fe. So here this is a displacement reaction. So here what is given? A bit displacement, where is it? R. So for this option R is the correct answer. Cu plus O2 gives rise to 2CuO. So here what happens? Cu plus O2. So here more reactants became single product. So this is what? Combination. So here this is P. Chemical combination is P. PbNO3 twice plus 2Ki becomes. See here Pb and I along with that K with NO3 twice. So here they exchanged their atoms. So this is called double displacement, chemical double displacement. So here is S. Now CaCO3 becomes CaO and CO2. Single reactant become more products. This is decomposition. So this is nothing but Q. And here C6H12O6 plus 6O2 gives us to 6CO2 plus 6H2O. This is the reaction of respiration, that is T. Now let us see the options here. AR, BP, CS, DQ, ET. See here AR, AR, BP and CS, DQ and ET. So option A is the right answer for this question. If you feel this video is helpful to you, please like, share and subscribe our channel. And please do not forget to press the bell button so that you will get the notifications from our channel. Thank you very much.